Hey everyone, this is Scott from Forgot to Grow. Well, welcome to our Penny Dreadful City of Angels Season 1 Episode 6 Thoughts video. Just finished watching the latest episode of Penny Dreadful, and I'm just going to be sharing my general thoughts on the episode. So in this episode, we see Tiago and Lewis are interrogating a suspect in the murder of the police officer, even though Tiago knows this whole time that it was his brother who did it. So this episode was really interesting because we have this dynamic of Tiago trying to convince this kid to confess to the murder he knows his brother did. Well, this kid also knows that Tiago is trying to do that because it's his brother. And this whole time, Lewis is just hanging out being like, what is going on? Like, what is... I know there's something happening that you two aren't telling me. I'm smarter than you two think. So yeah, I really enjoyed this episode, actually. It's kind of brought me back into the series a little bit, even though it still won't give me any of the stuff I want with the folklore and exploring more of the Santa de Morte stuff. But this one was a little bit more interesting based off of just a police procedural, a little bit more through the character development aspect, where we learn a little bit more about Tiago in this one through him trying to, like I said, convince this kid who they arrested last time to confess to the murder of the cop who his brother had killed, who Mateo had killed. And so this episode was really interesting to see that dynamic, to see the side of Tiago who was just willing to literally do anything to save his brother, to, you know, save his family. And so that was an interesting side. Like, obviously, I knew he was, you know, always, you know, like, he liked his, loved his family and would do anything for them, but I didn't know he would go this far. So it is interesting to see, especially since they keep bringing up this idea, is he more... So especially considering the idea that they keep bringing up of, you know, is Tiago more a police officer, or is he more Mexican, and which one is he, where do his true loyalties lie? And it seems in this one that it's definitely more so with his family, at least, maybe. And so that was really interesting dynamic to explore in this, and the like side of Tiago we learn a little bit more about. I also liked the, kind of how Lewis responds to it, you know, Lewis being like the thing he was most hurt about was that he was lied to by his partner, who he's just trusted and like showed nothing but trust and showed that Tiago could trust him. He just, you know, had to be willing to. And even like, even after, you know, Lewis is after, I mean, Tiago tells Lewis, you know, or Lewis actually puts it together. Tiago doesn't actually tell him. Lewis finally puts it together. And even after that, and he's pissed off and he's just like, you couldn't have just told me, we could have figured this out a little bit. This would have been so much easier if you just told me sooner. Fine. And then he goes and solves the problem, which is my favorite part of this whole episode, is how it ends, which is Lewis just sits down with the kid and's like, let me tell you a story, kid, and just proceeds to just talk this kid into taking the rap for not only the murder of the cop who, you know, Diego's brother Mateo had murdered, but also for the family that we've started this whole season off investigating, the murder of that family. So this whole, like, the fact that A. Lewis was just a pro and was able to just convince this kid to take the rap for everyone, to be kind of, like, considered a hero to the community of, like, you know, trying to, like, A, you know, being a hero to his community by taking the rap for this stuff, and just how Lewis just talked him into it and was like, you're doing the right thing, kid, taking on this burden. And it's just like, wow, this episode was pretty intense with that. I just, again, you see the side, these sides of Tiago and Lewis that, you know, I didn't love the side of Tiago we saw in this, you know, him trying to convince this kid to take the rap for his brother. And then we see Lewis, this loyalty in Lewis, who's just willing to, like, you know, help his partner, brother, who he's never met, who he doesn't even know existed till they tell him, you know. And so it's this, I really just like exploring that side of Lewis where, you know, he comes out at the end and he's like, okay, that's how it's gonna be. And so yeah, I thought this episode was really great to just kind of see these different sides, like I said, of the different characters. Yeah, some other things that kind of intermixed a little bit with this, it was mainly this episode was mostly the interrogation with Lewis and Tiago interrogating the kid. But the little things that happened along the side is we also see Dr. Kraft is throwing his wife out and gets her committed to an asylum, which I was just like, oh wow, what is going on with that storyline? Why is Magna convincing him to leave his wife and send her to a mental institution? For what? I'm just so baffled by that whole storyline. And we only got, like, literally one scene of it, of, you know, him throwing his wife out, pretty much telling her this is over, and that I'm a doctor, and you're a drunk, and no one's ever going to side with you, which is a fair point, but it's also kind of mean to say to somebody you're throwing out. So it was just kind of, yeah, that whole little scene of that, I was just like, what is going on? Why do you keep giving me little bits of this? What is happening? What is going on with Dr. Kraft? Are you just in here because you played a character in the other Penny Dreadful and they just need to bring you in for a role? What is your purpose? What are you playing? I'm just very curious to see where that ends up going. But yeah, that's so we see that, and then yeah, there wasn't pretty much too much else going on with anything else besides the interrogation. We do see, Tiago's mom and Mateo's mom goes and visits Mateo, which I thought was interesting that she knew where they were. And she mumbled something that I kind of missed onto saying how she found her. It sounded something like maybe magic. I don't know. But no, it was just kind of funny. It was an interesting scene to see, you know, Mateo, his mom being like, it's fine. You can come. It's fine. I know you have to, don't be with these people. They're not your family. And then him being like, nah, get out of here, mom. And it's like, oh, that's cold, man. Mateo, you were raised better than that. I know you were. So yeah, that was just another part that did just, well, happen. But yeah, that's pretty much all that happened in this episode. So I don't have too much more thoughts beyond just, it was interesting to kind of explore a little bit more of the sides of Tiago and Lewis in this via the interrogation of this suspect and seeing where they both stand. And then ending off with, you know, the whole PlayStation celebrating the fact that they've solved all these murders with one like nice bow, which is what the, you know, captain wanted all along, or the chief, whatever you call them. So yeah, there was interesting episode, but like I said, I'm still super curious about what is happening this whole season, because we've now solved the murder that started off the season, but we haven't, I still don't know what Magna's doing. I still don't know the ties to Santa Muerte. Like, I don't understand what is happening with the show a little bit. So this episode was better, just as an overall just enjoyable episode to watch, but I'm still like, the premise you guys hooked me on to this show with has not like appeared at all since the first episode. So I'm very curious what Magna's up to. I'm very curious what's going on with the whole storyline, how everything's gonna tie together, why Dr. Kraft's here, why is all this other stuff, why are we following all these different characters, the councilmen and the Nazis and all these different things. I'm just curious to see where it all ends up going. So they definitely got me at least hooked still, that I'm gonna keep going. A couple episodes ago, I was a little bit ready to leave. It got me uncomfortable with some stuff that was happening, but we're moving a little forward a little bit, but I'm still just want to know what's happening. So yes, I'm very curious to see where we go from here, but for sure let me know in the comments below what you thought about this latest episode. If you're curious about more of my thoughts on Penny Dreadful and other TV shows, I've linked my TV show thoughts playlist at the end of the video. But thanks again for joining me today. Sure, subscribe to the channel if you haven't already, and have a good one.